Crazy Boy Productions. Today we got the man of the hour, Mr. Nigel Long. How you doing today, sir?
Good.
Yes, sir. First of all, I just want to say congratulations on the hire.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? For me, I know for other people in the Valley, this just isn't another hire. You know what I'm saying? This is a black man who worked his way up the ladder
the right way
and worked to earn his spot. So just want to congratulate you on that.
Appreciate that, man. I really do. Thank you.
I should have seen it coming back then, though, man. We played you guys, Rebels versus Tijuana Red, back in 2017. You know, we hosted a tournament.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? We came to the game, like, you know what I'm saying? Way better than Rebels. You know what I'm saying? Like, underestimating y'all.
Yep.
Like, but y'all came to play. You know what I'm saying? That's probably one of the best games we've ever been in.
Yeah,
like,
man.
Double overtime. So.
No, I mean, you hit the nail on the head. Going into it, you know, everybody talks about, you know, Tijuana Red, Allentown and whatnot, and LNL Running Rebels, Bethlehem area, and, you know, there was so much hype going into the game, and, you know, you all have done an awesome job, you know, the last 10-plus years, you know, in developing kids and helping kids get to the next level. And, you know, so for us, it was a really cool opportunity. And, you know, for me, you know, coaching that game, it was crazy. You guys played a wonderful, like, really good game. Y'all beat us, and, you know, going double overtime, man, just there was a lot of respect level, you know, that grew in that game. Not only in y'all program and how y'all run things, but then, you know, also just our kids. You know, our kids got an opportunity to go up against y'all. So I was appreciative of that.
Yeah, man, I should have seen it coming back then. But
thank you.
Nah, to get into things, like, you know what I'm saying, you attended Freedom High School under Coach Delago.
Yep.
Just take us back, you know what I'm saying? Take us back to those playing days and, you know, how you were as a player and, like, you missed those days. Crazy Boy Productions.
So I've always been short, so my big thing was to give 100% effort and energy in everything I do, because I had to, because I was short. So, you know, working hard was, that was second nature to me. And, you know, Coach Salato, you know, I give him 100% respect and for what he's taught me throughout my life in the game of basketball, how to run a program, you know, how to give back to the community and just have unbelievable energy. And I remember those teams, man. I mean, we would have the stands packed, you know, the riot squad and whatnot. And we'd always, you know, when we played Liberty twice a year, sometimes three times a year, you know, those games were packed and the floor was moving and whatnot. It was good, man. I'll forever be grateful for my time at Freedom. So,
what's the feeling gonna be like coaching him this year in one of arguably the biggest crosstown rivalry in the Valley? How's it gonna be?
It hasn't hit me yet. I'll be honest with you, but when we do end up playing them, it's gonna be, you know, emotional. I'll say, you know, it'll definitely be emotional because I've been there as a player, and you know that rivalry, that's big. You know, crosstown rivalry, like you said. And it's important to our kids, it's important to the people in our program, and I know that, and I've lived that, so it'll definitely be emotional for sure.
Shout out Coach Salado, man. We got a lot of love for you.
Oh my God.
And you took the 6A crown this year, so we're happy for you.
Yes, sir.
So, following with Freedom, you attended Catholic University for a year, and then ultimately decided to finish out your career at Muhlenberg.
Mm-hmm.
What led to that decision? Like, what factors went into that?
Yeah, so definitely. So, you know, everybody, I had a wise person tell me once, you know, you have positives and negatives in your life, right? And people talk about that all the time. And Catholic just really wasn't a fit for me. You know, everybody asked me that all the time. You know, I went there thinking, you know, going to D.C., that was going to be a great opportunity for me. And, you know, when I got there, it just wasn't the right fit for me, both academically and athletically. So, you know, I decided to get a little closer to home. You know, I knew Coach McCleary well, just from my time in high school, just meeting him. And then there were a couple other players, you know, Nick Rindock and Gene Lee Baez, who, you know, are really good friends with me, that are lifelong friends, that were also in the program as well. So it was an easy transition for me, and honestly, it was the best decision of my life. I had the greatest 3 years of my life, you know, over there on Chew Street. So
you think that benefited you to be around those people that you, you know, built relationships with in the past?
Oh, definitely. I'd say, you know, those individuals are lifelong friends. You know, the teammates I've had, the people that I was with those 3 years over at Muhlenberg, I have lifelong friends, and you know, I'm forever grateful to have that opportunity to be at Muhlenberg. So,
yeah, I remember I called you, you know, for college advice, and you told me the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Just get in a situation where you know you're gonna be comfortable. You know what I'm saying? Be around people that care and believe in you. So I just took that to heart.
It's important, man. It's always important to surround yourself with good people. I mean, surround yourself with people that care about you. And you know, ultimately, you want to continue to grow. You know, and you know, I'm proud of you for deciding to go to Franklin and Marshall, because not only from an athletic perspective, they have great tradition and history, and it's a league. I mean, the Centennial Conference is one of the best conferences in the Division III basketball. Mm-hmm. But then academically, where you're going to take yourself, you know, as a person, as a leader, as a man, is awesome. So. You know, Franklin and Marshall, that's a great decision for you, man, and I'm proud of you for that.
Appreciate that, man. Mm-hmm. But let's get back to Coach McCleary. Mm-hmm. How does it feel, like, you know, you played under him, you played under him, mm-hmm. and then to coach under him. Like, what's that like? Like, what's going through your head when you get high? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what goes through your head when that happens?
You know, the secret to basketball is it's not about basketball. About the relationships and the people. Somebody told me that recently, and it's true. You know, Coach McCleary, for me, he's not only just a mentor, but he's a friend. And he's somebody that, you know, he saw that I wanted to continue and advance in this game on the coaching side of it. And he always gave me an opportunity to do that. So when he actually got the position at Bethlehem Catholic, you know, it's ironic, I was texting him and congratulating him, and he had offered me the opportunity, and I said, why not, you know?
Yeah.
A way for me to further my career, you know, in the coaching side of basketball, but then also I was familiar with not only yourself, you know, just JP, Kyle, so there was familiarity there, so it was a great opportunity for me, so I said, why not? And I'm forever grateful for him, I'm forever grateful for folks like you, because not only did you guys, you know, it was a fun 2 years, but you also showed me how to be a champion. You know what I mean? So, for me, like that, I'll be forever grateful for my time over at Madison Avenue, man. That was fun. That was a fun time, so.
Right, a lot of great memories, man.
Definitely.
In these 2 years at Becca, you know what I'm saying, where we were league champs, district champs, you know what I'm saying? We had a up and down year this year, but, you know, it was still a good experience. Chad Landis steps down as coach at Liberty after a really good year. Were you surprised to see that?
Yeah, I was surprised. You know, just the year that they had, I mean, going, winning plus 20 plus games last year, and just, I know, playing against him as a player and coaching against him, I mean, just an unbelievable job he did with the kids in the program. And, you know, Liberty has had a long story tradition. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this is just a wonderful opportunity, man. And so, you know, I was surprised, you know. But the reason for why, you know, I respect the hell out of him, mm-hmm. you know, spending more time with your family, I mean, that's something that, you know, I hope to have a family one day.
Right.
And so, you know, that's honorable. So
that's big, that's big.
He's a really good friend of mine, and he's somebody that I'm definitely going to be talking to, you know, throughout my time at Liberty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm sure he's happy. Seeing Coach Landis step down after a really good year, what made you apply yourself to become Liberty's next head coach?
Yeah, so it's crazy. You know, I have a lot of great mentors in the game of basketball just from my time as a player and as a coach now. And I remember Derek Mims, the father of the Mims twins over at Freedom, he gave me a call. And,
man,
you know, he was like, hey, you know, what are you doing? You know, how are you doing through the COVID situation, staying healthy? And then he was like, you know, there's a lot of jobs open. Are you gonna apply? And I was like, you know, I've been looking at a couple, you know, but I haven't, you know, submitted my resume yet. And he said, you know, well, you need to do that. Get an opportunity to understand the process, understand, you know, just going through it through the interview process. So I did. And you know, the rest is history. So I think a lot, you know, obviously this is a wonderful opportunity, and mainly I thank him for that. So
shout out to Coach Mims. Yeah. Shout out to the Mims students. We're gonna get y'all on here. But yeah, if he would have never sent that text, like we were just talking about it, if he would have never sent that text, then, you know, who knows if he would have been in this position.
It's the truth, man. You know, knowledge is power, you know? And, you know, for him, it was like telling me, Nigel, you just got to go through the process. Understand, you know, what that interview process is like, what they're looking for in a head coach. And then that'll better me in my next opportunity, you know, in my next interview opportunity. So.
Being around you these past couple years, I've gotten to know you really pretty well. And I know that you're a really humble dude, but you know what I'm saying? I feel like you deserve a lot of praise for this accomplishment, because it shows that we as a people can do these type of things with the strength of our power. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of self-hate in not only our community, but throughout the world. And, you know, we all need to rally around you for at least this moment, and, you know, realize that we can do stuff together. You know what I'm saying? We need to cut out all the self-hate and, you know, just come together for you and appreciate this accomplishment. So, like, what are your thoughts on that perspective?
Appreciate it, man. I know it's important to, you know, evaluate, do some self-awareness, evaluate where you are in your life, and, you know, what you want to do, and then surround yourself with people that have that believe in you, you know? That belief is important. I've been blessed to have friends and mentors in my life that believed in me, you know what I mean? And that helps me, that helped me attack this opportunity. And you're right, I mean, people in our community, we gotta do a better job of supporting each other. At the end of the day, I mean, you know, we could wear different colors, be on rival teams and stuff like that, but at the end of the day, we're still from the same place, you know what I mean? And so we just all gotta come together and support each other. And the work doesn't stop. You know, for me, it's just beginning. So now it's just now taking this to another level and giving others the opportunity to have, you know, situations like I'm going to be in with Liberty. So I'm grateful and blessed, but I can't tell you how appreciative I am of the people in my life that believed in me.
So the Lehigh Valley, it's a very traditional area. It's had a lot of traditions for years. And I feel like you've already broken one of the barriers by becoming Liberty's first black head coach, and one of the few black coaches in Lehigh Valley history, head coaches, that means. So do you see this becoming a trend in the future?
I hope, you know. I hope it's a trend, you know. First I hope that, you know, people like myself and others who have been awarded this opportunity give back to our community and teach young African-American males and females, you know, what it takes to get to this point, you know, and all it takes is just education, you know, and, you know, that knowledge, like I said, knowledge is power. So I'm hoping to pave the way for this to be a trend, you know, and but at the end of the day, it should come down to your qualifications, you know,
for sure.
Not necessarily your the color of your skin.
Yeah,
I think
sure.
Oftentimes, you know, we all look at the color of our skin, and that changes how you might view somebody. It should be the qualifications. What makes you qualified for that position, you know? So I'm excited, though.
Father, he has a great relationship with my father, and I know that he's impacted a lot of people. So how big of an impact has he had on you, and how proud of you is he?
I mean, without me getting emotional about it, you know, he's been an unbelievable influence in my life. Not only being my father, but, you know, my friend, somebody that I can lean on and show me the way, you know. And he always told me to always give back. He always taught me to give to others, be a servant. And, you know, this opportunity was something that I wanted to do, not only just, you know, just him being proud of me, but, you know, his father as well. You know, he was a coach, so my grandfather, and just saw how he gave back to the community and how people just really appreciated him for the servanthood that he did in his life. So to answer your question, you know, I'm so grateful to have the father that I do have, and I love him to death for it. So.
This concludes another episode of Mad B-Ball TV. We're very fortunate to have our brother Nigel Long here with us today. Congratulations again, man. We're proud of you, and you know, we're gonna be here to watch your success.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you. I appreciate the work that you guys are doing, man. I'm excited to see where you guys take this, man. So, thank you.
Mad B-Ball TV, exclusives only. Here we are.